CHVRCHES Podcast number 2 for July 9th, 2016. That you should go, come in misery where you can seem as old as your omens. And the mother we share will never keep your proud head from falling. The way is long, but you can make it easy on me. And the mother we share will never keep our cold heart from calling. In the dying light, I'm the only one here, and I will cover you until you go.
Check out the effect is important for the churches. Because in July 5th, 2012, the churches performed an 8-year gig at the art school in Glasgow, Scotland. So, 4-year anniversary for that. Playing there in the Czech Republic. Maybe we went to Spain on July 7th, because it's 2 days ago. And there's a lot of positive buzz on Twitter about that show, by the band, hearing from the crowd. A lot of memorable memories are made there, and the enthusiasm the crowd was highlighted in several tweets by some churches that were on Twitter. It also mentioned that the Polite Show at the Open Air Festival has a lot of the end that's available, including the full shows to get out of the tents. But definitely, it's posted there on YouTube. Crowd there was great. So, the coming church of shows, there's a lot of nice things going between now and coming up in the year. So, starting off with July 5th, we're going to be doing the Latitude Festival in Ireland. We're going to the Latitude Festival in the UK on July 16th. And off to Germany, Toronto, and Seattle. Sunday, September 24th. And then also, there's something that's going to be broadcasted live on the internet from KAEXP Radio at 3:30 p.m. Pacific Time. That's in the United States. That's a time zone where I'm actually in, so they're going to be playing something live there, and that's going to be broadcasted with the band of shows. Once they finish that, they're going to go back to Europe, wherever they want to, until they have to play again in Sweden on the 11th of August. They're going to do a series of shows in London, Norway, then Finland, Hungary, Belgium, Netherlands, and they finish up on August 20th in Portugal. Then we'll have a short break, and then we'll end the run of late August with two shows, one in the UK and one in France. The first one in the UK is the Leeds Festival on August 27th, and then the one in France is Rock the City on August 28th. Then we'll then have another short break, we'll make 2 weeks or so, and this will be the last day to run in 2016, and start off in Atlanta, Georgia, September 17th at the Music Meet. Festival, and then we'll be off to Providence, Rhode Island, Portland, Maine, Pittsburgh, to Milwaukee, and then we'll do two shows in Mexico, one on the 28th of September, and another one on the 1st of October. Then we'll then head back to Los Angeles for two shows on Hollywood Forever on the 3rd and the 4th of October. And then we'll finish up on October 6th in Tempe at the Marquee Theater, which is a makeup show that they had from earlier this year. Because a band member Hillness to wrap up the band's second album tour, and they will definitely need some rest and relaxation before charging batteries to get ready for album number 3. So you can check out CHVRCHES at chvrch.es/shows for more information about their shows. And speaking about that site, since the last podcast, there are no new shows since we published. So, at this point in time, the schedule seems to be pretty set in stone. So, let's switch gears and move on to a song. I'm going to play a couple of arms. This is a song that I got recently from a CD I ordered from Amazon. I called the Digipack version. It's a really similar to me open an arm. And it has a this picture song in open arms. It's different than the Holy Open Eye Special Edition, which is what I had before this. Open Arms is a song number 12 that's between Afterglow and Blue Way from the Special Edition version. And this Digipack version also has two live performances from the Pitchfork 2015 festival. The two songs will be The Choice and Forest Blue. So with the Pitchfork 2012 festival being held in July, this is definitely before the Holy Open Eye official release, so this is a treat for those folks attending over here, these two songs from their album before they actually release them, and their recordings are on this Digipack release. So, these are sold in the United States for right now, just a Target Theater one. So, if you come on eBay or to Amazon, you can hopefully find your own copy if you don't have one right now. Here's a segment for
I'm waiting for the last So we have a total of four news stories here. First up, there's a new animated video of the church's Bury It with Haley Williams. It's going to be out on Monday, July 11th, so coming up here in 2 days. And I would like to mention that the church's Bury It song featuring Haley Williams has been jumping up in charts. Media Base Alt has it as the number 46 song, and apparently it's been played during the official tracking period 183 times, which is up 73 points. And I'll have a link to the church's Facebook page, which has a little sample of the animated video if you're listening to the podcast right away, or if you're listening to it much later, then you'll probably already be able to see the full video, which will be released again on July 11th. So our second news story is that Lauren Mayberry fans suggested that we cover Scottish Album of the Year Shortlist Award, and that Martin's father accepted their award because they were on travel. And I'm going to go ahead and play that segment from that I captured from the video, which you can watch the whole video online if you'd like to, and the link will be in the show notes. In the video, you'll also hear from one of the judges, Colm McAuliffe, and he has some pretty nice words to say about the churches and some of the songs and what he thinks about their work. And there's also a message from the churches that was recorded by them in an airport, which is why Martin's dad was at the SHAY Awards picking up the award for the band.
CHVRCHES! Yay! Glasgow Electric Pop Trio CHVRCHES were first nominated for the SHAY Award in 2014, and they return with their second album, Every Open Eye, which crashed into the UK and US top 10 last year. What an achievement. The band have their roots in Glasgow's DIY indie scene, but they have won the world over with their gleaming synth pops, euphoric dance floor anthems, and glorious R&B.
It's a magisterial album from start to finish, and it's quite staggering in the range of scope and ambition on display, which is far from anything parochial. It's quite universal. You have this magnificent pop sheen, but behind that there's real substance, and there's real quality behind every single one of those songs. So that really, really stood out for me.
CHVRCHES!
Well, unfortunately, the drawback of having acclaimed Globetrotters on your shortlist is that they're trotting around the globe. But CHVRCHES have found the time to record this message for us.
Tonight because we are in an airport just about to travel off on tour, but we want to say thank you guys very much for putting us in the shortlist. We are really proud to be from the place that we're from and to be a part of that community, but we think it'd be a little inappropriate for us to keep the money, so we are going to give the money to Sistema, a charity that works with youth groups in Scotland. Thanks guys.
Cheers.
Thanks very much to CHVRCHES for recording that message for us. So here to accept the SHAY Award on behalf of the band, on behalf of CHVRCHES, please give a huge Paisley welcome to Mr. Martin Doherty Sr. Yay!
Hi there. I've been warned by my wife not to say anything profound, because I'm not capable of that. But since the band weren't really heard, I'll just say that I know it was really important to them, and they were delighted when they made this shortlist. And considering the standard of high standard of music that there is in Scotland at the moment, who are very, very pleased with us, you know. So really, just to say on behalf of Lauren, Ian and Martin, thank you very much for those who nominated Every Open Eye for this award. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Martin Senior. Could be the speech of the night, actually.
So the third story out of four that I wanted to cover is just real quickly, the churches have been very vocal about the UK's exit from the EU, the Britics mess that they've gotten themselves into. And I just have a link to a couple of news articles related to that in the show notes. The churches find the overall vote disconcerting, especially considering that all of Scotland actually voted to stay in the EU. So that being said, so the links will be in the show notes if you want to see some of the comments that were made by the churches. And the last thing I wanted to mention is that over on Reddit, there's a churches group, started a new fan discussion site on Discord, and I'll have a link to all that in the show notes, how to get connected to that group over there. That was the last bit of news, so we'll just move right into the interview the churches did at Coachella 2016.
Now, some of you out there might be seeing churches for the first time. For others, they might be the reason you're watching today. We're joined by churches right now backstage. Coachella, hello.
Hey, what's up? How's it going?
How are you?
We're good, yeah. Thank you for having us in
Absolutely.
This lovely little jungle.
Isn't this beautiful?
It's very nice. You lucked out, I think.
So welcome back to the festival. I have seen you here before. Talk about why this festival is special for you guys.
This is the one that's... It kind of starts off festival season, you know. It's always the one that people want to play. It's always the one that gets talked about. Mm. It's right up there with Glastonbury, you know.
Yeah.
When we played here in 2014, it was kind of... It ended up being a really big moment for our band. It was a really big springboard for the rest of our campaign. Mm. And, you know, when they asked us back, we were really excited about it.
Yes.
It's going to be special, I think.
Now, with all that considered, do you feel a pressure to bring kind of even more to the stage with your performance?
In situations like these, there's a football analogy that people use in the UK called play the game, not the occasion. And it's to keep people, keep their heads right in cup finals and stuff like that. Mm. The same thing kind of stands for something like Coachella, I think.
It's just like any other gig, really.
You can't go out and try, if you try and go out and give everything, you end up, you know, maybe you let yourself down for whatever reason because you were psyched out.
Yeah.
So I have to treat it like another show and try and enjoy it. That's the important thing.
Do you have any pre-show rituals?
I guess today we'll apply sunscreen to our normal rituals. We don't have to do that when we're playing inside. But yeah, normally we just kind of do vocal warm-ups and listen to some tunes to get in the mindset. And then today, yeah, sunscreen.
Almost. You know, it's sad. That's a question that comes up a lot. I feel like we need to get a good fake answer.
I thought my original rituals. Answer was good, the black mass answer.
No.
Sacrifice some
chicken. That didn't go down that well.
No?
No.
Well, where would you find that on the Coachella site?
You bring your own chickens.
They don't have passes. They can't come in. Anyway.
So can people expect anything? We're about to see your performance. You're about to hit the stage.
Yes.
Is that? I don't want to spoil anything, but do you have any holograms?
You've got all the holograms.
We're not here. Yeah. I don't know if you noticed.
We're VR. That's what we are.
I think it's just going to be the three of us. But I like to believe that we can put on a decent show between the three of us. We've done enough shows now that we know how to.
We've no excuse.
How to do it. So
and
you've
done really well in the last couple of years and become quite popular. Do you consider yourselves a pop band?
I think that term is just in constant flux. I don't even know what a pop band is now, you know. Some of the most successful music that you hear on the radio now doesn't sound to me like pop music anymore. It's a lot of pop music is actually a lot weirder than supposed, you know, left or center indie music.
Yeah.
So I don't think we identify completely with that term, but I'm not afraid of it either. You know, if people want to call us a pop band, I don't have a problem with it. I probably wouldn't call us that myself.
Fair enough. So I want to show off the vinyl that is right here, conveniently.
Look at this.
Shiny.
Not everyone does vinyl, so congratulations, and this is very cool. And I want to point out that it's 180 gram, 100% virgin vinyl.
Hmm. It's made of the blood of virgins, yeah.
Yes.
No. Yeah, I was totally. Like, what does this mean?
We're going to carry on this black mass analogy.
Understanding of it.
I'm assuming it's because, like, sometimes press implants recycle lacquer, and maybe this has never been pressed before.
Not the case.
No, I actually don't know, so I'm just making that up.
Well, I love it. And there's a download card, so you can get it digital as well. The album is Every Open Eye. CHVRCHES, thank you for joining us backstage. Have a great show at Coachella. And are you going to be able to hang out and enjoy the rest of the festival?
I think once we clock off the set, I think we will definitely have some beers and get messy.
Yeah.
So
any picks for people? Any undercard choices?
Always. Mm. They're on this afternoon.
Okay.
We had them out on a show with us just the other night, a side show. A fantastic band.
Excellent.
Really cool.
All right. That's CHVRCHES. They're about to hit the stage here at Coachella 2016. Thanks.
Again, that was an interview that the CHVRCHES did at Coachella 2016. Two little comments. They had a question about pre-show rituals, and the band in the interview didn't say very much about that. But one of the things I experienced when I saw them at the Fonda in LA in December of 2015 was they came out, they did their first song, and then they said, hey, we usually do a fist bump before we start, and we forgot to do that. So we're going to go ahead and do that fist bump. And they all got together and they did the fist bump, and then the show continued. So I guess they do have a pre-show ritual. Maybe that didn't come to mind when they were in the interview. So the other thing is that they, at the very end, there was a question about what other shows they would recommend seeing at Coachella. And they mentioned the band Always, which Always opened up for the CHVRCHES here in San Diego in, I believe it was March. And they were great, so I would recommend them if you haven't listened to them before. So that covers all the content for today's podcast. You can contact us at CHVRCHES Podcast on Twitter or www.CHVRCHESPodcast.com, all one word. Again, I'm totally open to any feedback on the format. What's missing? What could we do better? If you find an article that you like or an interview of interest, then please send it my way, and I'll put that into the podcast. I would love for somebody to volunteer to find a great interview and then basically cover it in a little segment, and then I can just drop it into the podcast in post-production. So basically everything's on the table, live or recorded, so just let me know. I would greatly appreciate any additional help. So one of the things I thought would be interesting for the podcast in general is to end the podcast with a song that's not a CHVRCHES song, but something that is meaningful either from electronic music perspective or directly to the band. So I'm pretty excited to end the show with the New Order song Temptation. So Martin mentioned he was very honored opening up before New Order at the Glassbury on the other stage. Billboard reported that Martin said, and these are his words, "We're performing before New Order," said a respectful Doherty, "one of the most important electronic bands of all time." So with that, and after I saw that, with that quote, and then I also saw him actually speak it when I watched the video after the fact. So I reached out to him on Twitter and asked, which New Order song should we end the podcast with? And he, of course, picked Temptation. So here it is. We're going to end the show with that song. So here it is from an album called Factory Records Communications, 1978 to 92 U.S. version, which is a collection of music from Factory Records during that time period. There's like 56 total songs in this collection. The song Temptation from New Order, and we'll close out CHVRCHES Fan Podcast number 2. Have a great day. I'm The CHVRCHES Fan Podcast is licensed under Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 4.0 International License by Steve Holden and AztecMedia.net. All rights reserved 2016. Fair use notice. Reference material and media have been placed within this medium for informational, educational, and discussion purposes only, in compliance with the fair use criteria established in Section 107 of the Copyright Act of 1976. It should also be noted that the opinions expressed on this podcast are those of the hosts and are not endorsed by the hosts, previous, current, or future employers or advertisers, or any entity officially associated with the CHVRCHES.